I gotta pee. Nobby. Well, today we're going to cut a pee nobby, and this little fella, I'm not sure how it's going to cut. It is, it has some really nice blue and green color in it, but it could be really watery color, or it could be really strong. I just can't tell from the outside because the skin is too rough. So what I need to do is clean it up. There is a nice bar and there is a nice piece of potch in there on the back of it. So it should be an easy cut. It just depends on how good this stone's going to be. So let's start examining the piece on the wheel and we'll have a crack and see if we can get a gem. So this is what you call a pea nobby. It's a perfectly, well not perfectly, but a very round little gem or little piece of opal. It could be formed in potch, it could be formed in full color and crystal or black or dark. And you just don't know how it's going to cut until you get in there. Some pea nobbies can be really, really nicely clean skinned, and you can see through them and be very obvious what you're going to get. This one is a little bit harder because of all the sand on the outside. Now you can see that there's some potch on the back. I am hoping that that potch turns black, and I think it does because that color is looking pretty dark from what I can see. So if we get on the wheel, I'm going to have a bit of a study of it. Now the color bar seems to go around the edge, potch is down here, color is on top, and it seems to go around. Now the sand here I think will start to eat the stone away because it dips too far into the color. So I'm going to have to grind that side in first to see how far it goes. And then we'll work on all the way around, we'll work on seeing how big the stone could possibly be. So let's get into this one. That color bar is coming quite clean. So I'm going around, as you can see, I'm going around and I'm making sure that that color bar is showing up all the way around so that we know we can pretty much take that top off and know that there's going to be color underneath there. So it's looking okay. There is one downside to this stone. It hasn't got that healthy potch. It may get darker further down and better, but so far the potch is not looking healthy at all. That's not looking good. So this is a really interesting piece. It has beautiful black opal, and that's the stuff that we're looking for. But it has that potch on the back, and I think I mentioned this potch a few weeks ago on a video about that cancerous potch on the back, and it's not good for the stone. So I think I have to, no choice, grind that potch off the back to keep the stone nice and clean. That potch on the back, this type, is puts pressure on the good quality opal, and it can make the good quality opal break. So I think it has to go. So I'm going to put it back on the wheel. We're going to lose a fair bit of height because it's a nice high dome, but I think that's the sacrifice we have to make this stone safe. So there we go. I've ground all the not so good potch off the back. Sorry, wheel's still turning. all the potch is off the back and it's nice, all decent colour all over. Now, this piece didn't need any potch to keep it black. It's naturally black in the colour, which is quite rare, and that's what becomes a black crystal. If you have no potch on the stone and it's still very dark, that's what you call a black crystal. So this one will probably end up being a black crystal. And if I shine the light through it, you can see that there's actually some healthy potch inside the color. So that's what's keeping it black. So inside it, that's what's keeping it black. So it's actually not a black crystal. There's still some potch just under the color, which is quite cool. How about we cut this stone and see what it comes out as a value? Thanks for all the comments also from last week about the patterns. There was a lot of patterns I didn't cover. It was just a few of the main patterns that I covered, and I could go on forever about patterns in opal. So a lot of you asked about honeycomb opal or honeycomb pattern, and that's not really a pattern that shows up in Australian opal, so I don't really cover it. I don't do much with Ethiopian, or actually don't do anything at all with Ethiopian opal or hydrophane opal. So I'm only going to really be teaching you about Australian opal, mainly because it's the best in the world, and it's the brightest in the world, and some people may be biased and say no it's not, but when you look at the history of opal, black opal from Lightning Ridge has fetched the highest price per carat of any opal in the world. So it's proof pretty much that is the best type of gemstone in opal. So let's get cutting. So I've decided to polish the back of it as well because the colour is quite nice. And then, so you can decide which side you want to actually set the stone, so it should be quite nice. So I finished polishing the opal. It's a nice black opal. It's very, very dark, even though it has no distinct potch line on the back. It's just naturally black. It has some potch inside the stone to keep it dark as well, but it's really, it's around about an N2, so it's still quite dark. But the brightness is also around about B2. And from 1 to 5, the B2 is kind of around about where it's at. Now, it's 1.31 carats, and a value would be around about $500 for the stone. Not bad. So that was worth cutting that stone out of that nobby, and I'm quite pleased with it. So I hope you are too, and I hope you learned something about that potch. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.